Good evening. Victorians are bracing themselves for hotel quarantine's biggest test yet. The third version of the much maligned program will start taking arrivals tomorrow. International passengers will touch down at Melbourne Airport for the first time in almost 2 months, and the government insists this time it'll work. Dougal Beatty with more.
After almost 2 months without an international flight...
Hi, how are you going?
..return travellers will finally begin checking in to Victoria's latest incarnation of hotel quarantine.
Just don't touch any of the walls or the doors, please, and it will automatically go up to your floor.
Tomorrow, guests will be escorted to their rooms...
And this is your room here, sir, room 1209.
Cheers, thanks very much.
Thank you.
..with COVID testing doubled...
Going up to nurse, just relax, going in...
..to 4 swabs during their 14-day stay.
All done. Okay. Thank you.
It's the third version of the program, one the government insists is as safe as possible.
We've gone through these hotels room by room, floor by floor, to make sure that they are safe.
Ventilation systems have been upgraded and workers are tested daily on site, introducing incentive payments for voluntary testing on their days off. Most hotel quarantine staff will be fully vaccinated by the end of April. Employees who refuse will be redeployed.
Will we continue to work with those people who haven't been vaccinated yet, encouraging them to be vaccinated? But the important to note is that every single staff member who is working in these hotels will be vaccinated.
But as revealed on Nine News, unlike some states, guests who test negative will be allowed out of hotel quarantine on compassionate grounds to visit a dying relative or attend a funeral.
Our staff escort them the entire way so that they're not in the community without our staff, in full PPE and ensuring socially distanced.
A new feature of the hotel rooms is negative pressure. That means there's increased airflow in the corridor, so if a door is opened, it's going to suck air into the room rather than push it out.
We're really confident in those rooms that are negatively pressured.
Initially, arrivals will be capped at 800 people a week, scaling up to 1,120 by next week. 6 hotels will be included in the program, including the Holiday Inn at Melbourne Airport, the Intercontinental, Novotel Ibis Melbourne Central, the Pan Pacific, the Holiday Inn on Flinders and Element Melbourne in Richmond. Each adult guest will be charged $3,000 and it's $500 for children for a 2-week stay.
I'm nervous. I think all Victorians are nervous because the government's got it wrong twice in the past. And when the government gets hotel quarantine wrong, they throw us into lockdown.
OK, let's go live now to Dougal Beatty, who's at Melbourne Airport tonight. Dougal, where will the first return travellers go?
The Holiday Inn at Melbourne Airport and the Intercontinental Hotel in the city will be among the first to house return travellers. Now, the government says that those ventilation issues at the Holiday Inn have now been fixed since that outbreak back in mid-February. A further 6 hotels are expected to come online in coming days following remediation works. Now, there is more than 100 return travellers that are going to be touching down in Melbourne tomorrow on board 5 flights. The first will be touching down at 4:30 in the morning from Sri Lanka, and that will be the beginning of the first real test. Tony?
Thank you, Dougal.